This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Apollo Creed is a fictional character from the Rocky films, initially portrayed as the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. He was played by Carl Weathers. He is a tough but agile African-American boxer with a Larry Holmes-like jab, and his name is a reference to the Apostles Creed. The character was inspired by the real-life champion Muhammad Ali, having what one author remarked as the same brash, vocal, theatrical personality. Protagonist Rocky Balboa, Creed's rival in Rocky and Rocky II, faces underdog odds 5-1 in Rocky II and views Creed with respect, pointedly refusing the prodding of a reporter to trash talk against Creed by laconically remarking, "He's great." In Rocky, Creed essentially cleans out his division of serious challengers and magnanimously decides to fight rookie contender, Balboa. For the fan spectacle in the film and its sequel, Balboa and Creed find themselves basically evenly matched in the ring, ending up friends by the third movie. Creed had multiple nicknames, including most prominently the Master of Disaster. Others include the King of Sting, the Dancing Destroyer, the Prince of Punch, and the Count of Monte Fisto. A 2013 poll of former heavyweight champions and boxing writers, including former WBA heavyweight star James Bonecrusher Smith, ranked Creed as the second best boxer in the Rocky series. All of Creed's championship fights were scheduled for the 15-round distance. Championship fights did not convert from 15 rounds to 12 rounds until 1982 WBC, and 1988 WBA and IBF. Contents 1 role in the series 11 Rocky 12 Rocky 2 13 Rocky 3 14 Rocky 4 15 Rocky 5 16 Rocky Balboa 17 Creed 2 Fighting Style 3 See also 4 references role in the series Rocky. Apollo Creed first appeared in the 1976 Oscar-winning film Rocky as the charismatic, intelligent, and undefeated 33-year-old world heavyweight champion. A planned bicentennial fight against number 1 contender Mack Lee Green was scheduled for January 1, 1976, which Creed gladly hypes whenever someone places a microphone in front of him. However, Green hurts his left hand in training, and when none of the other top-ranked contenders, such as Joe Chack and Buddy Shaw, step up to face the champion, Creed responds with a promotion that will generate huge publicity. He will offer an unknown local fighter an opportunity to battle for the title in a match in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Upon reviewing the local boxers in Philadelphia, Creed is drawn to a club fighter named Rocky Balboa because Balboa is Italian and has a catchy nickname, the Italian Stallion. Creed also explains his choice by saying, "Who discovered America? An Italian, right? What better way to celebrate its 200th birthday than to get it on with one of his descendants?" Creed brushes off the idea of the left-handed Balboa giving him a fight, pledging to knock him out in 3 rounds in spite of his trainer's concern when he sees Balboa in a television interview, training by punching sides of beef in a meat packing plant. Creed puts more effort into giving everyone a good show rather than training for the bout when the match takes place. Creed dresses up like both George Washington and Uncle Sam in the pre-fight festivities, with his matching trademark stars and stripes boxing shorts, and is in a jovial mood until Balboa knocks him down in the first round with a single uppercut. The first time Creed has been knocked down in his career. He then endures a grueling 15-round fight with Balboa, who gets to his feet after Creed takes him down with an uppercut in the 14th round in what appears to be the end of the match. This was the first time anyone had ever taken the champion the full 15 rounds. Both fighters are beaten, bloodied, and bruised by the end of the bout, Balboa with severe eye damage and Creed with internal bleeding. Creed gains a controversial split decision victory, and neither fighter wants a rematch, at least at that moment. Rocky II in the second film, Creed immediately demands a rematch in the hospital or after the fight. In fact, he challenges Rocky to finish the fight right there. Creed's desire for a rematch with Balboa intensifies when it becomes clear that the prevailing public opinion is that Creed had been paid to intentionally carry Rocky for the 15-round distance instead of knocking him out early in the fight. Eager to change minds and ignoring the pleas of his staff, Creed challenges Balboa to a second fight on Thanksgiving Day, 1976. He uses various humiliation tactics to coax Balboa out of retirement. Rocky had married his girlfriend Adrian after getting out of the hospital from the first fight. Creed insists at the press conference that he would drop him like a bad habit and tells Rocky when he leaves, "Come November, you're mine." In a press interview during training, he also insists that Rocky cannot last 5 minutes in the ring with a superior athlete like me. Creed plows through sparring partners and trains harder than ever before, with the intention of punishing Balboa for the embarrassment 11 months earlier. Mickey trains Rocky to become faster by chasing and catching a chicken. Unlike their first fight, Creed dominates Balboa throughout the second fight, thwarting Rocky's strategy of fighting right-handed. Despite this, he is unable to make good on his promise of an early knockout victory, as Rocky absorbs his punches by the final round. Creed is well ahead on points, however, he also endures a substantial beating in later rounds, when it becomes apparent he cannot knock Balboa out, and Balboa begins landing his own punches on the tiring Creed. Not wanting a repeat of the first fight and ignoring the pleas of his trainers, he vows to knock Balboa out rather than taking the safer route by winning on points at the beginning of the 15th round. He tells Rocky, "You're going down," to which Rocky replies, "No way." After going toe-to-toe for much of the final round, Creed is knocked down by a left from Balboa, with Balboa falling down in exhaustion as well. Rocky gets up by the count of 9, but Creed is unable to pull himself up and is counted out, losing the match and the championship by knockout. His first professional loss. Apollo retires from boxing soon after. Even though he has lost, he gains his respect from the crowd back, since it feels that he fought and lost in a fair fight. The fight also results in Creed finally acknowledging Balboa's ability as a fighter, rather than seeing him as a fluke. Rocky 3. In the third film, a 39-year-old Apollo Creed appears at the first fight between James Clubber Lang, 23, and Rocky Balboa, 34, as a guest moderator. This is a match at which Lang defeats Rocky by KO in the second round. Before the match, the former champion Creed steps into the ring to greet the fighters. When he steps up to Lang, the latter slaps away Creed's hand and mockingly insists that he don't want no has been in my corner. He further says, "You want to jump, Creed jump." When Creed walks away, stunned at this rude display from the belligerent challenger, Lang laughs at him and calls him a chicken. Following the match, Balboa's beloved manager Mickey dies, determined in part to put the disrespectful brute in his place. Creed finds Balboa at Mickey's gym and they agree to have Creed take over as Rocky's manager. The pair travels to the Tough Gym in Los Angeles, California, where Creed used to train in preparation for a rematch with Rocky. Creed encourages Rocky not to ignore the naysayers that say he is too old, but instead refocus himself. During this talk, he states, "Now when we fought, you had that eye of the tiger." This quote is referred to throughout the movie, including the film's theme song, "Eye of the Tiger," by Survivor. Creed mentions that Rocky will owe him a big favor once he wins, which he does not specify at first. Rocky's training is geared toward making him quicker and more agile to counter the larger, stronger brawler. Creed teaches Rocky his Creed's own fighting style. Rocky has trouble concentrating during his training, suffering from guilt over Mickey's demise and self-doubt. Adrian helps Rocky recognize this as a simple fear of losing again and convinces him that he can't let fear control his life and that he has to fight again, not to prove a point but to live without fear. Rocky agrees and begins to put his fear aside. Creed helps Rocky rediscover the fire inside, which he had lost in the time leading up to the Lang fight that had won him the title. Creed calls this fire the eye of the tiger. Before the match begins, Creed expresses his confidence that Rocky will win. He gives Rocky his signature colors, Creed's stars and stripes boxing trunks, to wear during the fight and tells him to wash them afterwards. Re-energized with Creed shadow boxing in his corner, Rocky regains his title with a 3-round knockout of Lang after his victory. Creed reveals his favor, a third fight with Rocky, not as a bloody fight between bitter rivals, but as a sparring match between friends. Rocky happily accepts the challenge. The film ends showing each boxer hitting the other at the same time, symbolizing the equality of their greatness. It is revealed in the 2015 film Creed by Rocky to Apollo's son that Apollo won this fight, the result of which was kept secret until that time. Rocky 4. In 1985, Apollo, 43 years old, comes out of a 5-year retirement to fight mammoth Soviet Olympic boxer Ivan Drago, who has come to the United States on behalf of the Soviet Union to enter the world of professional boxing. Not wanting the Soviets to appear superior to American fighters, the patriotic Apollo challenges Drago to an exhibition match and calls out Drago at the press conference that sets up their exhibition bout at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas, Nevada on August 31, 1985, highlighted by a pre-match rendition of "Living in America" by James Brown. Apollo enters the arena from a descending scaffold overhead, dancing to the music in his old red, white, and blue Uncle Sam outfit with Rocky, Duke, and Polly in his corner. Apollo is overly confident that he can dispense of Drago with ease. However, Apollo is not ready for the extreme size and strength of the Russian. After taunting the Russian and landing a number of ineffectual punches, Creed is pummeled badly in the first round. Rocky wants to stop the fight, but Apollo refuses. Apollo tells Rocky not to stop the fight, no matter what, no matter what. By the start of the second round, Drago pummels Creed with ease. Rocky again tries to stop the fight by throwing in the towel. Apollo tells Rocky not to stop the fight, giving Drago a chance to deliver a fatal blow as Rocky drops the towel, causing the fight to stop to Apollo, who dies in Rocky's arms in the middle of the ring. Drago wins by technical knockout. Rocky then sets out to avenge Apollo's death by beating Drago in the Soviet Union, with the Soviet premier and the Politburo looking on. He succeeds as the film ends with Rocky winning the fight by knockout in the last round. Rocky 5. With his character's death, Carl Weathers departed the franchise after Rocky 4. In Rocky 5, the fifth installment of the series, after Rocky Balboa defeated Ivan Drago, Apollo's trainer, Duke congratulated Rocky by showing that he made everyone proud, especially for Apollo, by holding up his red, white, and blue trunks. Apollo was thereafter only mentioned briefly in past tenses, including a flashback scene between Mickey and Rocky before Balboa's first fight with Creed, where Mickey states, "Apollo won't know what hit him." Rocky's pupil Tommy Gunn also claimed to have been a fan of Rocky since his first fight with Apollo. Tommy was eventually allowed to wear Creed's trunks. There was a poster of Apollo and Rocky during the events of Rocky II in Rocky Jr.'s bedroom before the Balboas went bankrupt during Tommy's fight with Union Kane. Rocky commented that it was like his own first fight with Apollo. Later, during Rocky's street fight with Tommy, he began to hallucinate and saw images of Apollo's death at the hands of Drago, believing that he was about to suffer the same fate. However, a vision of Mickey telling him to get up gave Rocky the strength to win the street fight. Rocky Balboa. In the sixth installment of the Rocky franchise, Rocky is seen paying tribute to Apollo by telling customers at his restaurant stories about his friendship and fights with him. In a deleted scene, when Rocky wakes up, Rocky sees Polly sleeping, and Rocky sees a photo of his first fight with Apollo, but his face is censored and Rocky's face is covered by a scrap of paper with Polly's head. During the commentary before the Rocky vs. Mason Dixon fight, a montage of Rocky's opponents is shown, which excludes his two fights against Apollo Creed. In the seventh installment, it has been revealed that Creed had an affair sometime before his death, and from that, Adonis Johnson. Creed was born after his biological mother's death in the late 90s. Apollo's widow, Mary Ann Felicia Rashad, adopts him at a young age. Not only does he possess the boxing skills of his father, but also his fiery temper. Years later, presumed to be a well-educated young man, Adonis Michael B. Jordan leaves his job to pursue a full-time career in boxing. He first seeks tutelage from Duke's son, Lil Duke Wood Harris, who runs the Delphi Boxing Academy. Duke refuses to work with Adonis to ensure his safety. Adonis, to his mother's dismay, moves to Philadelphia to seek out Rocky while meeting up at Adrian's. Rocky is surprised when Adonis mentions a third fight between him and Apollo that happened behind closed doors, presenting himself to be Apollo's son. Rocky compliments his father's boxing ability and reveals that Apollo won their third match when the word got out that Adonis is Apollo's illegitimate son. The media heavily publicized the story of his infidelity, which catches the eye of the trainer for the reigning light heavyweight champion, Pretty Ricky Conlan. Tony Bellew. Both parties would want the fight to happen, however, on the condition that Adonis would assume his actual name instead of his mother's last name, Johnson, to which he agrees. Similar to Apollo's desire to select Rocky due to his nickname, the Italian Stallion. Leading up to the fight, Rocky has been diagnosed with cancer, which greatly impacts Adonis' behavior, which gets him incarcerated for the night while Rocky visits him in prison. Adonis angrily blames him for his father's death, while Rocky tries to calm him down and understand Apollo, who isn't there to defend himself after getting his mind straight. Adonis makes a pact with Rocky that they would both fight their respective battles together in Liverpool. Adonis receives a gift from Mary Ann, boxing trunks that heavily resembles his father's trunks, who he passed to Rocky, who he passed to Tommy, the machine gun. The fight presents many parallels to Rocky and Apollo's original fight, with Adonis assuming his trainer's role. Conlan presents an unrelenting attack on Adonis, in which he knocks him down after a less-than-stellar introductory round. Adonis finally manages a right hook strong enough to cut Conlan by surprise in the 11th round. After an intense flurry, Conlan manages a strong shot that seemingly knocked Adonis unconscious. However, Adonis sees visions of his relationship with his girlfriend and Rocky's ailing composure, but finally wakes up after seeing a vision of his father in his prime, which baffles Conlan and the audience. Before the final round, Rocky is adamant on stopping the fight to save Adonis from the long-term effects of his injuries, a decision he contemplated 30 years after Apollo's death. However, Adonis wants to continue to fight to prove that he is not a mistake. After the revelation, Rocky tells Adonis that, though he's never had the chance to thank Apollo for stepping in when Mickey died, it does not match what he's done for him and that he loves him. In the closing seconds of the fight, Adonis finally unleashes a style that is comparable to his father's and Rocky's, and manages to knock down Conlan for the first time in his career. A split decision determines Conlan the winner of the fight, and gives Adonis the ultimate respect, telling him that he's the future of this division. During the post-fight interview, HBO boxing analyst Max Kellerman asks Adonis what he would like to say to his father, to which Adonis tearfully says that he loves him and he knows he didn't leave him on purpose, in which he concludes the interview saying he's proud to be a Creed fighting style. See also, Muhammad Ali in media and popular culture. In the film series, Creed is known as one of the world's best fighters, possessing a combination of great speed and strength. His powerful jab and emphasis on agility complement his flashy personality and outfit. In terms of weaknesses, his only major drawback appears to his deep sense of pride and strong self-confidence, which allows Rocky to get an edge over him in the ring from surprising Creed like Ali. Apollo was an outside fighter, relying on his speed and power to get through fights. His jab-cross-hook combination were his mainstay, and, also like Ali, Creed's defense was heavily contingent upon his speed. Apollo used Ali's float like a butterfly, sting like a B philosophy, being able to slip and evade blows and frustrate his opponents. A notable difference was that though Creed had Ali's unorthodox hand positioning, he ducked, bobbed and weaved in the classic style, as opposed to Ali, who preferred to move backwards, in contradiction to boxing's basic tenets, but with success. Perhaps the reason for this was that only Ali could be that unorthodox and look convincing, where most boxing instructors would tell you that you can't land a punch when you're retreating backwards. Ali did that too with regularity. Also, unlike Ali, Apollo wasn't very political and had very little to say on social issues. In Rocky I, a reporter asked him if it mattered to him that he was fighting a white man on the most celebrated day in our country's history, to which Apollo replied, "About as much as it matters to him that he's fighting a black man on the most celebrated day in our country's history." Like Ali, Creed was susceptible to taking a lot of damage during fights because of the level at which he held his hands, a fact which ultimately proved to be his undoing. See also film in the United States portal. Mason Dixon references Carrot. A. B. Jacobson, Matthew Fry, 2009. Roots 2, White. Ethnic Revival in Post-Civil Rights America. Harvard University Press. ISBN. Carrot. Randy Roberts, James S. Olson, Winning is the Only Thing, Sports in America Since 1945. Books. Googlecook P. Films. Rocky 1976, Rocky 2 1979, Rocky 3 1982, Rocky 4 1985, Rocky 5 1990, Rocky Balboa 2006, Creed 2015. Characters. Rocky Balboa, Adonis Creed, Apollo Creed, Ivan Drago, Tony Duke Evers, Mickey Goldmull, Clubber Lang, Adrian Penino, Polly Penino. Music. Rocky, Gonna Fly Now, Eye of the Tiger, Rocky IV, Burning Heart, Hearts on Fire, Living in America, Rocky V, Rocky Balboa, The Best of Rocky, Rocky the Musical 2012, Creed Video Games, Rocky Super Action Boxing 1983, Rocky 1987, Rocky 2002, Rocky Legends 2004, Rocky Balboa 2007. Real Boxing 2, Creed, Rocky 2015-16. Related. Anderson v. Stallone. Rocky Steps. Rocky Statue in ZTEAST. Rocky 6 1986.